castle mod. Let me show you some of the new things. I don't have everything done yet, but and I've done some upgrades to my castle. So since we're in the bedroom, the first thing we're going to start off with is put in a bathroom, because you got to have one of those. And you can actually sit on the toilet. Unfortunately, the door opens up, so yeah, that's not cool. But it actually acts as a compost bin. Let's see if I can. Nope, apparently I'm not ready to poop. So we'll go ahead and hop off the pot. And so one of the first things I want to show you guys is with the update, we got two switches. And the switches, so let me... Where's that? All right, so with the switches, we got an actual drawbridge. And alright, so it says for you can set up, so you can actually have it, there's like three doors nearby that it can, I can set it to activate, and one of three. Let's see, so that's one of the things that was included in the new update. We also have a new decoration, basically these shields, and there's actually a third shield, Berserker shield. So those are the three new shields and decorations, but you can also craft those shields and actually use them. As a matter of fact, right there. So I have one already crafted. And let's... Oops. So that's what the new shield, one of the new shields looks like. I, of course, painted it black and red. But there you go. So then... Oh, let's see, nothing new in here, I don't think. No, I didn't have anything in here. Okay, I did add a greenhouse. This allows the crops to grow a little bit quicker. It also protects them. Well, if I didn't live on an island that there were no wild animals on, it would protect them from that. I added, of course, a scarecrow, which I think actually lights up. I don't think the dodo pen was new, but I'll tell you what is new. There I have another gate. This is the new stable for the horses for mating and whatnot. Ooh. Level that guy up. Let's level him up real quick. Increase his speed. Maintains. Oh yeah, check this out. You're gonna love this. Ready? So that's the new building. I also added a dock. Really more like a pier. But you can go out here, you can sit in the chair and actually go fishing. Of course, there's no fish in the water. So that sucks. But I can go out there and sit and watch the sunset. So So part of the update, we have a new blacksmithing table, and we get this is where you make the shields. Matter of fact, excuse me, the round shield and the kite shield. We also have a trebuchet ammo storage. But there's also not just the some structures, storage. We have the mangonel. Let me go ahead and make one of those. We have a pyre. So you can capture somebody, put some shackles on them, throw them on the pyre, light it, walk away, and they burn up. Kind of gruesome, really, but you got to be in a multi-user server. I can't do it, use it on the on my solo. We have new siege weapons, so we have the a mangonel, which is basically a catapult. It's a small siege weapon that shoots medium-sized rocks, causing moderate damage. Then we have a trebuchet, which is a large siege weapon, and I have one sitting out back. It does incredible amounts of damage over a great range, but it does take a long time to load and to fire. And then we have a petard, or petard, sorry. It's just a crude explosive device for use against structures. What you do is you put it on an enemy structure. Hit it with the torch, run away, because you got about anywhere from 5 to 20 seconds to get away, and then it blows up, and all hell breaks loose. Again, being on a solo server, I don't have any enemy buildings, so I haven't been able to see that one go. But let's see, what do I need for? I need stone. Throw some stone in there because I'm going to make some ammo for that trebuchet out back. I also have a new foundry, keep foundry. It basically has a larger storage capacity, 60 units as opposed to the smaller forge, only having like 6 or 7. Go find some stone. Any stone here? Aha, we do. Right, so let's grab some stone. What is that? Oh, obsidian. All right. And I'm only gonna make, I think, one or two chunks of ammo. Let's go ahead and get that real quick. No, that's not what I want. Well, guess I'm only going to get one. All right. So let me It's the pyre I have built. I don't necessarily need it. And so yeah, the ammunition weighs 80 pounds, so wanna make sure you've got plenty of room to carry stuff when you go making that. Okay, so let's go show you the trebuchet. Alright, and that's this big looking thing right here. Now I have it currently pointed off over the ocean. But that is really not where I want to set it. So we're going to aim it back to the right. Oh, awesome. Okay. Alright, so I come out of there. That's about where I want it. I'm aiming for the big mountain back there. So I can set it. Pitch is at 10 degrees. If I wanted it a little higher or lower, I could. So it's setting itself. Alright, now it's ready to be loaded. You'll notice the pot's on fire. That's cool. And we're going to go ahead and let loose. That's pretty cool. So great against buildings, not great against other players or dinos, because once you fire it, it just takes too long to hit something. Although, if you hit it in front of them and they're not paying attention, they could run through the fire at that point. But let's see. Now I had built a structure out here. For the see if I can test the petard, and that's what it looks like, and you're supposed to just be able to smack it and go on, but it won't light because it's on friendly on a friendly structure. So okay, well that is pretty much trebuchet itself. Let me get right. Okay. So it is movable, but it's about a 5-minute wait. Once you fire it, it takes 5 minutes before you're able to pick it up and move it, but you can. The storage unit for it, however, which is this, you can destroy it, but you can't move. Once you put it down, that's where it's at. And then as you add, so let's access the inventory. So you can have up to 10 rounds in the storage, and it basically makes it just a pyramid. I'm sitting here talking with my hands, and you can't even see me. So, and that is going to be it for this little video. Next video, I believe we're going to go fishing. We're going to go visit Horseshoe Island. And with that, I will talk to you later.